Hey, Ingo.
Oh,
hey, do you know what time it is?
Of course, it's time for 5 minutes with Ingo. Today we will talk about an important topic for data science, which is really about the preparation of data. There's two large groups of data preparation. One is called data blending. And data blending is about bringing data sets together, changing the format of data sets, and, well, working with your data. The other two, also important group, is data cleansing. Data cleansing is about improving the quality of your data, like replacing missing values. That's something we talk about a different time, but for data blending, this is the topic for today. And one thing is important. People believe that in total, we use more than 80% of our time for data preparation in general. So that's a lot of time, and I think actually this time is not an exact estimate. I think it's actually even more than those 80%, so it's important to talk about this. All right, let's talk about data blending. Let's talk and specifically about joins. And let's move over here to this little pool to talk about this. So if joins are one of the most important thing to bring together two different data sets, what we really need now is, well, two data sets. And it just happens that I have two data sets just in front of me. We actually have the rubber ducks here on the left side, and we have the rubber piglets here on the right side. And you see that we put some property here on the back of the rubber ducks and the piglets. And this is kind of like an ID. So this here, for example, is rubber duck number one. And we have number two here and all the others. But we don't have like numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 for the rubber piglets, where it starts at 5, 6, and then the other numbers. So those are our two data sets. And as you see that some of the data points that kind of match, they have like matching partners between the rubber ducks and the rubber piglets, but some others they don't. So let's see how we can match them up. There's actually multiple ways to do this, and let's do this in the right data space. And for those here, of course, that is our pool here. Okay, so we bring those data points in here. So we have those without any matching partner. We put them here on the left. Then we have a couple of data points with a matching partner. We put them here in the center. And then we do the same thing for the piglets here. Those with the matching data point, they actually end up in the center as well. And then we have a couple of piglets without any matching partner. Poor piglets here. Okay, so now how do we combine those two data sets with each other? Well, there are four different kinds, and they're called inner join, outer join, left join, and right join. So in many cases, all you actually want to get in the end are the matching pairs of data points. You don't care about those data points without any matching partner. So the end result here should really be about those data points in the center. That's also in the inner ring here. That's why we call it an inner join. And all you do really is you basically look for data points which match, like the rubber duck number 5 with the piglet number 5, and you basically create a new data set out of those two here. And then you do the same thing for the pair for rubber duck and piglet number 6. So, and you see, those become our new data set. And then also number 8. And you don't care at all about all the data points without any matching partners. So you just forget about those rubber ducks over here and the piglets over there. And that's what an inner join is. Let's bring those back into the pool. And let's now figure out what could an outer join be. Well, you might think it's now only about those without any matching partner, but that doesn't make any sense at all, because that would just mean, well, you have a couple of data points where you have, well, those piglets here and a couple of data points here, but nothing matches at all. That can't be about bringing two data sets together. So it has to be really about like, well, maybe we basically say like, okay, we take all the data points, so we take the same pairs here and turn them into our data sets, data points, wherever they match. But then also we add those piglets here, and they form additional rows in our data table, but they don't have any matching values for the piglet, for the ducks. So they just stay empty, and we do the same thing for the rubber ducks. And so they don't have any value for the piglets. So this here really means we have three sections, the matching pairs, and then basically everything else as well. So all the data points play a role, but some of them have some matching values where they don't have a matching partner. So that is an outer join. A little more unusual, I would say. Okay, so those are inner joins and outer joins, but there are two more called left and right join. So let's have a look how those could look like. For the left join, you really focus most on the left data set and you just want to match it up wherever you can. So you basically start with the data points here without any matching partner and they become the first rows of your resulting data set, but since they don't have a match, they'll stay empty again. But then we also have this group of matching data points we already have seen before and they become the second part here and they form basically additional rows with the matching partner, and that really means you now covered all of the left data set and not all of the right data set because, well, you only found the matching partners. Since you covered all on the left side, that's why we call it a left join. Well, you can probably guess now that a right join is very, very similar. I mean, in this case, you would focus on the right data set, all the piglets here, and match wherever you can match them and keep the values empty for the rest of the data sets wherever there is no matching partner. So those are all four types of join.
Hey, Ingo, you just said that the outer joins are not very common. I have a question. Is there any type of join which is more frequently used than the others?
Oh, I'm really glad that you asked that one. Yeah, I would say so. I mean, there is no like rule or like a law that you have to use inner joins or left joins more frequently. But I would say both the inner and the left join are used more frequently. Why? Because often, if you really match up two data sets, for example, to build a training data set for your machine learning model, it's really about getting the full match wherever you can. So that's where inner join makes most sense because you end up with most information for the data rows where you have all this information for. In other situations, one data point is more important than the, or data set is more important than the other one. So it's either left or right, but often I start kind of like with the more important one first. So that makes left data join for me like a strong contender in terms of like frequency of used. But outer joins, I have to admit, is a little bit less common. And I mean, right joins could be as common as left joins. It's really just a matter of how you view it. And yeah, that's from me today on joins. Thank you for watching.